Paramahamsa Nityananda, a compelling spiritual force of our millennium, founder of an international socio-spiritual movement, pioneer of a modern Vedic Renaissance. Born in the sacred town of Tiruvannamalai, a yogi by birth, fearless spiritual explorer, beacon of divine power, Paramahamsa Nityananda is today an inspiration for millions on the path. Adept in ancient mystical yogic sciences, researcher of the science of spirituality, guru for enlightenment. Every year, Paramahamsa Nityananda shares with over 1 crore people worldwide the treasures of his wisdom, the joy of his laughter, and the incomparable power of his initiation. Now, Paramahamsa Nityananda speaks on living enlightenment, solutions for blissful living. Join us for an unforgettable spiritual experience.
Just as the embodied one goes through tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness, and infirmity of old age in this body, in the same manner it takes on another body, the awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed by these changes. You don't worry when your boyhood turns into youthfulness, because you just know you are going to continue to exist. Then why do you worry when the old age turns into death and assuming another own body? Because you are afraid you may not continue. I tell you, anybody with a simple logic can see how can life end with one body? Just to do this drama of 100 years, I don't think you need so many tools and weapons and instruments like a mind, intelligence, consciousness. No. The fear of discontinuity is only for those short-sighted fools. Please understand, Krishna is not promoting any religious concept or philosophy. He is not teaching any theology. He is talking to his close friend who is in a big crisis, he is counseling his personal friend who is in a big crisis. He is naturally not only honest, too straight. Come on, Arjuna. Just as the consciousness goes through the tenderness of the boyhood and bloom of the youthfulness and infirmity of old age in this body, in the same manner it takes another body. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed. I am not able to add one word in this verse and delete one word. There are many other translations which says very blindly, oh, just like a spirit passes through a childhood, youth and old age. No, the spirit does not pass through childhood, old age and youth. It goes through the tenderness of boyhood, bloom of youthfulness and infirmity of old age. Please understand, it goes through only the characters of boyhood, youthfulness and old age. The awakened one who knows this does not get perplexed by these changes. If there is a philosophy in this verse, I can expand and create a theology. Even if there is one small unnecessary thing stretching, I can create a hanger and hang all my coat. But here, Krishna is so straight. I can't hang any coat around it. I can't add any stories, anything to it. It is straight truth. I want all of you to understand. Drop all the fears you carry about the discontinuity. Whether the wealth, money you accumulated in the outer world, or the wealth, all the great qualities you accumulated in the inner world, does not get disconnected due to your death and next birth. First thing, please understand, there's a beautiful picture our research team has brought, maybe from ISKCON collection, the courtesy of ISKCON. Please understand, the sacred secrets from this great verse. First thing, you just move from one body to another body, just like how you move from boyhood to youth, from youth to old age. Same way you just move from old age to death and death to again birth, next womb, next birth. And from birth, again childhood, then youth. You don't lose anything. Understand? This is the first thing. Second thing, maybe you will believe this much. I think I don't lose my inner good qualities. The karma comes, the mental pattern comes with me, I know. But what will happen to all the wealth I created? Don't worry. You take birth again in the same family, same type of family. I don't want to say same family, same kind of family where the same amount of wealth is there. So don't think you will die as a billionaire and take birth roadside, live in slum. No. Neither the great qualities you accumulated in the inner world nor the wealth you accumulated in the outer world is lost by death. Understand? Same way, if you accumulated tremendous laziness in the inner world and poverty, which is side effect of the laziness in the outer world, even death cannot take that away from you. After death also, that will continue to be with you. So if you want to transform your life, do it when you are alive. That is why I am saying, suicide is not the way to escape from any problem. Just few days before, one of our ashramite's mother committed suicide. The ashramite ran to me and informed, this is what has happened, Swamiji. Immediately connected with that soul, the person who committed suicide also has seen my, had my darshan, she was also a devotee. When I connected, I saw she was crying to me profusely, saying that I had a tremendous pain. I don't know what to do. I thought I'll escape from the pain and committed suicide. Now I understand the pain is 1,000 times more, 1,000-fold more. I told her, "Are you have done NSP and how many times I have told you suicide is a sin?" She is telling, "No, in the peak of the pain, I forgot everything. I jumped." Anyhow, finally, because devotee, what to do? So on my special quota, I released. Of course, each incarnation have their own special quota. They can veto. And I released and said, "Anyhow, you have to take another one birth, but you will not hang without having the body. The ghost period, I can discount it. But you have to have one more birth. No doubt about it. That nothing can be done." I pushed her into another one body. Anyhow, she took another one body and now she is continuing her life. And again, I saw very clearly she is born with arthritis now. I could only do that much, that like a hanging over period. See, till her natural death time, she will be hanging around without a body. That will be too strong punishment. Too much. That period I reduced. She assumed a body. But already I saw she is having arthritis, means the whole body pain. Please understand, I am not telling you stories. I am revealing the sacred secrets to you. I am revealing the science of life and death to you. Gita should not be looked like a religious scripture belongs to a sect. Short-sighted people, fanatic people think Gita is a sectarian book, belongs to one sect. No. Gita is the book of universal sciences. I can tell you at least 100 important sciences necessary for you to live in this universe is described in Gita. At least 100 sciences. I can give you some example. Now in this sutra, the science of life and death.
Welcome to Inner Awakening, the most powerful personal transformation retreat you could ever experience. In just 21 days, thousands are already experiencing the shortest route to constantly high energy levels, visible anti-aging, healing of chronic diseases, fulfilling relationships, and higher states of consciousness. What is the secret behind this transformation?
Kundalini means the inner potential energy. Once it is awakened, opens the different doors for the conscious experience in you. I can say which is a master key for all extraordinary spiritual experiences.
This extraordinary program is conducted personally by Paramahamsa Nityananda in the vibrant atmosphere of Nityananda Dhyanapitam Ashram. Open yourself to the benefits of Nitya Yoga and practical meditation. Experience physical and mental healing. Discover simple ways to handle life with success. Above all, enjoy individual darshan and blessings from Paramahamsa Nityananda every day. Take 21 days for yourself and carry home the transformation of a lifetime.